Amen, amen, amen. I'm going to read this to you as a kind of like a prayer. It's one of my favorite songs. And it goes, "Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like. But I've heard the tender whispers of your love in the dead of night. And you tell me that you're pleased and that I'll never alone. You're a good, good father. It's you who are. It's you who are. It's you who are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide. But I know we're all searching for answers that only you can provide. Cause you to know just what we need before we say a word. Again, you're a good, good father. It's you. It's who you are. It's a good, good. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Cause you are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect in all your ways. You are perfect. Praise the Lord. You are perfect. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Father. Bless you, Heavenly Father, for all that you have done for us, O Lord. For, Lord, looking to seek to dwell within each and every one of our hearts, Father. And we thank you, Lord, for we who are fathers, Lord, seeks the guidance of your Spirit, O Lord, that we can be like you, Lord. Lord, that we could show the image of you through our lives, O Lord. So, Lord, we could also be called good, good fathers, but in the earthly way, O Lord, because we know, Father, that only you can guide us and lead us and show us how to love our family beyond ourselves, O Lord. But, Lord, we honor you today, O Lord, for being that Father above all fathers. For you have been our Father even when we had no Father, Lord. For you are always with us to guide us and lead us, Lord. And Lord, I ask for a special blessing upon all the fathers, O Lord, because they are heads of the house of your people, Lord, and they are high priests of your temple, Lord. I ask for an anointing upon them by the power of your Holy Spirit, as only you can give. And Lord, we ask, receive our worship and our love to you in Jesus' name. Would you come up?
I'm sorry, when you stay seated for a second, I have a little treat for you today, okay? Before we go into singing praise, I want you to sit down. Hey, listen, last week I had the opportunity to go with a bunch of men to the Adventure Fest. All the men who went, if you could stand up for a second, come on. Stand up and just. Thank you. Listen, don't miss next year. I'm telling you, we had a blast. And what we're going to show you now is a couple of minute slideshow of what happened. So I want you to sit down, gentlemen, and just enjoy this and see what we did.
Thank you.
9 steps. We saw a snake, and hope next year I can go up those 1,000 steps. They're not steps, by the way, they're boulders. But I made it, 1,000, and I had a neat thing on. And some people didn't, but I'm not here to mention names. But you know who you are. Hey, let's, thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Father in heaven, we give you praise, God.
Yes.
We thank you for all our men, Lord God. We thank you for fathers, Lord. We
thank you, Lord.
Heavenly Father, thank you, Jesus, Lord. We thank you, Father, for sending Jesus to save our souls, Lord, to give us a chance. We thank you for how you forgave us, Lord. Your first act was even knowing that we would turn on you. You forgave us and sent Jesus. Even before you sent Jesus, you knew that you had to forgive us first for our iniquity, our sin, our transgressions, our walking away, our turning away.
Glory to God.
So, Father, we give you praise and honor and glory in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God bless you. You come up and take this pleasure. Play them drums for me. Thank you, Lord. Hey, let's all stand now. Give the Lord a big hand and give somebody a hug. And come forward. Grab somebody close. Thank you.
Let me try all the back and forth.
Thank you. It says, now let the weak say,
come on now.
I am strong.
Amen.
Not just doing some kind of positive affirmation, but Jesus shed his blood for you to be strong, for you to be healed, for you to be well, for you to be delivered. It's about time we start saying the opposite of what the devil's telling us to say. Quit saying you're sick. Quit saying you're weak.
Yes.
All those other four-letter words that the devil has you saying. Weak. Fail.
Yes.
Evil. All those type of things. So let's sing this again. Let the weak say, I am strong. And start thinking it to yourself. Make this a way you think, because Jesus paid the price. And the power of the Holy Spirit is in this room right now to start changing that thing around for you.
For us, and I
So good to see you out this morning. I want to wish all the fathers a happy Father's Day. Fathers to be, a happy Father's Day. For others who just take care of other people's kids, happy Father's Day. Thank you, Father in heaven, for Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you.
Respond in kind and do that that you have commanded us to do. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 And I just want to tell you, if you saw the Adventureman thing that you were here earlier, we showed it. Please go online and take a look at it. Jen, thanks for doing a good job. There you are. I want you to know that if there are any pictures of Hal, I took that picture. So it must really be a good camera because I'm not that good. I just held it down and one time I went, and I thought, I think I took a lot of pictures. So, thank you. Good to have you all here this morning. I want to share something with you first of all. See a good friend in the rear, man. Just it's so good to see you. I want you to cue up the evangelism thing that we're going to do in a minute, and we're going to receive, not take, not extract, not con you out of, but receive God's tithe and offering. And you don't got to give, but you get to give. Thank you for the mattress, by the way. It worked. It worked. Thank you. Thank you. I hear my grandson. Yeah.
I just want to say what a wonderful time of worship and it's so late when the Holy Spirit is here leading us. When we're, as the pastor said, when we're all on one accord, He is among us. If you didn't leave, you're not going to leave out here different than what you came in. We need to pray for you some more then, okay? Amen. I just want to encourage all fathers, men and women, you know, today is a new day. If we were talking about forgiveness in class, and you know how we have to forgive our fathers. You know, sometimes we gotta forgive our fathers and each others and our mothers, and you know, make a difference. Today is a new day. Just, you know, if we could start it like this, then you know, we could keep it going. Okay, amen, amen. Now back to it's now time to receive the Lord's tithe and offering. Amen. It's time to give back a portion of what He has given to you. Amen. You know He is good. Ushers, if you could come on down. And I just want to remind you, there's a textable number in the back, so you can, if you forgot your checkbook or if you forgot to stop at the Mac machine, you know, you could do the textable. It's very easy to do, okay? If you need someone to help you, just let us know. Okay? I love worship. It's just so amazing. You know, that's when you get the closest to God. It's just like so amazing. I don't know, if you don't feel it, I'm telling you, we gotta pray for you then. I'm telling you. Oh, thank you, Lord, for just being here today. Thank you for being our Father, Lord. If we could be just more like you, more loving and more caring for other people and more serving, because, you know, you could have been anything, but you became a poor person like us, you know, and so you could humble yourself and be there for everyone. You were around the sinners, you know, but to encourage them. Thank you for all that you do for us. And at this time, Lord, I pray for the offering, Lord, that you just meet all of the needs. Let multiply and do miracles, because we want to be able to reach out this community next week. We want to make a difference, and it's not for us, it's for you. There's people out there hurting that need to know about Jesus. We need to reach them. We need to feed them. Just like you told Peter, feed my sheep. Yes, Lord, we need to feed the sheep out there. We need to help them. And water, Lord, you know, water is free, just like Jesus. I love that. Thank you. Thank you, God, for all that you do for us. I pray over this offering and bless it. Bless it from the bottom of my heart, Lord. Amen. 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 You can get excited. Happy Father's Day. Amen.
Amen. There's Children's Church.
They're taking off right
now. They're taking off right now?
Wait for a minute. Wait for 1 minute.
Okay. Well, in that, we got an announcement. The Citrone concert is going to be on a Friday. There's a sign-up sheet in the back. Jennifer says she needs to know who's going, so that way she can report it. So today is the last day to sign up on that sheet to let them know. So they know how many tickets to have ready for you.
Thank you. Hey, listen, I was just going to share Sam Citrone. If you have not heard him, go online and type in Sam Citrone. Check his music out. It's going to be awesome. It's going to blow your mind. And he's such an anointed preacher and a friend, and they always take care of City Limits. So if he says, I want to know how many are coming, that means that they're going to put us in the front right there. And it's going to be excellent. They've got dancers, everything. I mean, if you ever want your kids to see something, I mean, drama and music and song and art all in one, this is what you want to bring them to. And so I would invite you. I'm going to go out and take it that day so I can go out and be with whoever goes. And I want to sit with you, okay? So let's sign up. Do it. And I'm telling you, listen, if you've never seen it, please go online and take a look at Sam Citrone online. And then say, I got to do this, okay? And make sure that you call us in so we can all sit together as a bunch and make noise like we always do.
Yeah. Amen, amen. Okay, Children's Church, children, you're dismissed for your class. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're the teachers. Praise the Lord. Well, we're on the threshold of a great, great launching. And what's our motto now, or saying? Live it.
Let's live it.
Let's live it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. So, Pastor?
Hey, listen, I just want to give you a little glimpse of what happened out last year. Maybe some of you have already been online and have seen some of the videos, but I just wanted to take a moment out, and I'm trying not to worry about time. And as you can tell, when the Holy Spirit moves, you just be obedient. It always works better that way. Amen. But I want to take a moment and show you, it's not the Adventure Fest one, it's the City Limits one for the evangelism. And as you can tell, every street here has been signed out for like a part of our city. All the team captains, I think all we need is one captain. I will let you know that I'm going to jump in there, but I never tell anybody until the end, okay? And then there's going to be a couple of cars and a truck that will be full of waters. People are bringing in waters. I want you to stop at the supermarket and buy a couple of cases of water, bring them in. And we have coolers, and we're going to fill the coolers up and then put them out there. Here, let me just... Can I get a few people to pass these out? This is a day-to-day schedule. Let me just explain it to you quickly, just so we know. Someone...
One per family.
One per family. Let's live it. So listen, I want you to... I'm sorry, can I have one just so I can see what I'm talking about? Thank you so much. So every day, as you look at that, I want you to think, listen to me, some of you are going to say, well, I can't possibly do this every day, I can't make it every day. Some people have actually taken a vacation week off and they're going to spend it with us. What we do is that we come here every single day. Now, these things are evangelism teams, so they need to be prepped every day, a flyer every day. The Lehigh Valley Zoo is coming 2 days, and we need to let people know that. So every day, there'll be a new flyer for every team captain and for your people. Is everyone following me? I don't want you to be confused with this, okay? Every day there'll be a new flyer for new information, what's going on that day, and then we're going to tell them that the Lehigh Valley Zoo is coming, or that there's going to be a kids program. On Thursday night is going to be a youth night, and there's going to be a dance-off, and we're going to give away a few bikes, gift prizes, things like that. On Friday, a Plena Tres is going to be here. Anybody ever hear Plena Tres? They're awesome, man. They're awesome, and they're anointed, and we're going to have an outdoor water baptism. Amen? So if you want to, I'm hoping that we have a sign up back there for that. If not, please get me one and let me know. If you want to sign up, Pastor Bevan Jacker in Chicago, she told me that next week she's coming in and she'll be doing a baptismal class, okay? So if you're not sure as to what it means, and those who were just with me and got baptized, it's just a way to refresh and say, Lord, I'm trying again, man. What's a saint, man? A saint is just a sinner who fell down and got back up again. Who fell down and got back up again. I get back up again. Amen? So here, I want to run through it with you. So every single morning is going to be breakfast from 8:30 until 9 o'clock, okay? We're just going to have breakfast. For anyone in the community, anyone who comes in, I had years when somebody told me, Pastor Jimmy, that kid took a bunch of extra eggs and a whole bunch of sausage, and I said, really? Give them more. Give them more. And they're like, shouldn't I be rebuking them? I said, no. Not at all. What would Jesus do? Come on over here. You hungry? Take more. You don't need to sneak sausages out of your pocket. We'll send you some if you want to take some home. Amen. Anybody follow me? Thank you. All right. One day on a Thursday night, somebody was out here. They said, see that kid, Pastor Jim? I said, yeah, Sam. What's up? I said, watch. This is his fourth time. He gets as many hot dogs as he can all over his arms and just walks away. I said, really? Load him up, man, and get him a little plate. He said, what? Get him a plate. Okay. Right. Because that's what we should do, is to receive them where they are, embrace them at the need, apply the word of God, cultivate fellowship, and help to mentor them to and through the cross, right? So it's like a whole attitude shift. It's like, man, we got to beat that golden rule. We were talking today in our forgiveness class in Thrive. And it was on the Amish people that forgave the shooter. Anybody remember that story when the guy went? I forget his name right now. But he went into the Amish school and he shot all those little girls in the head. And how all the Amish people, they forgave him. And not only forgave him, they came to his funeral. And not only that, they actually helped out with it and gave money towards it. And there were more Amish people than non-Amish people at the man's funeral. I mean, that's forgiveness. You follow me?
Yeah.
And that's what we want to do, is like show it off. And listen, the whole world saw Amish people as these brilliantly wonderful, caring, loving, and graceful, forgiving people.
Amen.
And honestly, what does forgiveness do? It just sets you free from being angry with somebody.
Amen.
I don't have to waste my time being angry. Amen?
Amen.
So anyway, if you look down, the kitchen setup, the EV prep. If you see that, that means that we'll come out here, see if any of these crews or teams, if they need new flyers, if they need a fresh batch of flyers. We'll have coolers for every street here every night, and we're going to go to the hospital or somewhere and get ice, load them with ice, put cold waters in every single one of them so that you can go out and give a cool water to somebody. And then teach you how to just do that. I mean, just start out by just handing them something free. Earn your way to have a talk, just like Jesus did. Can I get a cup of water?
Amen.
Yes, you can. And before you know it, that woman left and she said, come see a man that told me everything I ever did.
Amen.
Just a cup of water. That was cool well water I had, right?
Yeah.
So then it would come up to 6:30. Okay, every evening, even if you say, well, I work, I can't get here on time. We have showers all over this place. We'll get a couple of towels from the dollar store. I'll have some underarm stuff and some of that grease you put on your hair if you want. And so there's no reason not to make it. And if you just have your t-shirt, wash it every night and wear it every day. Bring it with you. Take it to work and bring it with you. And come here and have dinner with us in the back. All of us are going to have dinner together. Then we'll all come right out here and get in our seats and go together, hit the streets. There'll be so many of us, so many blue shirts, that nobody's got to be scared. All you're doing is inviting them back for the zoo, or inviting them back. And then if the Lord leads you, share the gospel.
Amen.
If not, then just walk it, live it. Treat people like you love them and like God. You know Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Then on Thursday, all of you turn up to the sanctuary every night, okay? We're going to go out for about an hour, 15 minutes, go out and then start heading back from our street. Assign street every day, and then start heading back and share testimonies. As you come back, I have cards for you, a prayer card or a salvation card, and we'll have them rolling from the night before on the screen so that you can see people's names. Team 1, pray for somebody. And if they don't mind it, we'll put it up. If they do mind, you just say, if you'd like me to keep this private, but just put the person's name and just put prayer request. Amen?
Amen.
Okay? Don't force it down anyone's throat. It's like, I had somebody who gave me an illustration that don't feed a baby with a garden hose.
Mm-hmm.
Right or wrong, you follow me with a fire hose. Can you imagine that? A baby needs to take an ounce, like, two sucks. I hear my little grandson say, all that work, and I'm thinking, a half ounce? You gotta be kidding me, you know? Anyway, are you with me? Then on Friday, on Thursday, it'll be our night outside. Everything will be done outside. And then on Friday, it'll be done outside too. Our baptismal tank will be set up. There'll be a little stage band set up, a sound system, and we're going to have a worship team come and do worship for us.
Amen.
How cool is that? Amen?
Amen?
All right. Now, let me take a minute and show you this little video and enjoy yourself. And Timothy, if you can get ready, I'm going to be turning my mic on so it may spike the sound. Make sure that it does.